Hey guys, Chameleon.com here, doing a review for the Cambridge Soundworks 735 radio. This is a higher end audio equipment company. Cambridge Soundworks has a ton of different stuff, everything from radios to speakers, so you should check out the Amazon link below to get this one today, as well as their full line of products. And we're just going to jump straight into the review, tell you what this thing is about, and why, actually, in my eyes, I would prefer it over a Bose system. So let's get started. So what it includes, it actually says it right here in the manual. We're going to flip through this thing because it might actually be hard for people to find this manual anymore. So we're just going to do a quick flip through. All right, so it comes with the Soundworks radio, which is that thing, a external AM loop antenna on top, a infrared remote control, optional iPod dock, which it came with that, and two adapters, actually, for different sized iPods, and then the external FM antenna and a user's manual, which we're going through right now. So I'm just going to go quickly through this thing, show you what it's about, and I'm also going to read off the Amazon listing. You guys can pause and read this at your own leisure. We're not going to go through this because I know everyone wants to get straight into the radio, but we're just going to flip through the pages really quick so you guys can see getting started, set up, how to put in the antennas. It's pretty self-explanatory. It also comes with the ability to have a 9-volt backup for your alarm. So if your power goes out, this thing's still running strong. How to set the clock, how to use the remote and how to sync it, all that stuff. This is tuning the stations either on the remote or on the interface itself. And actually, while I'm on the subject of that, the reason I prefer these Cambridge Soundworks radios over most Bose is that you can only control the Bose, usually, from my knowledge, from a remote. So if your remote dies or your battery's gone, you can't even change the stations on the thing, which is kind of a bummer. That's why you actually want to have its own independent, interface to where you can do that. Convenience features, snooze, big old snooze button on top. Sleep delay. I mean, there's a lot of features in this thing. Here's the full rundown. Music wake up, tone wake up, radio station presets. You can plug in your headphones. You can actually connect an MP3 player aside from the dock because there's an aux input. Switch between AM, FM, and aux. Power. There's a jog. I'm not sure what the jog means. AM radio band. Select radio on or off. Player input. All that good stuff. And I know we're going through this manual, but I want people to know what this thing is. Here's all the different features of the remote, just in case we don't go through them all. Here's how to change inputs, 3.5 millimeter jack. Oh, this is that's the radio rear. And then, let's see what else we got in here. Jog function, the jog button on the radio. I actually want to know what this means. Press the, and I think I missed a page before I go to that. Listening to external sound sources. Pretty easy. Just put in an aux cord and you're good to go. Radio and disc test displays. I don't think this takes discs, so that's not really needed. Jog function. Press jog button on the radio or on the remote. Control select first jog. Press the jog button again. Jog functions. Jog operation is canceled 5 seconds. I'm not quite sure what that means. Maybe you guys can tell me in the comments below. Here's a bunch of different displays with jog. Oh, also, this thing has its own subwoofer, so that might be part of the deal with that. Wake up functions, wake up buttons. Okay. Wake up functions, activating wake up, snooze. Okay. Player dock. This thing right here, it's for your iPod. Comes with two different sizes, depending on which iPod model you have. It's got a blue light when it's charging, I believe. When the Soundworks radio is on, we'll go and standby, control connected iPod. You guys can read all this on your own, because we're already 4 minutes into this. So you guys can pause as needed. It's got a composite cord. It also docks the remote, which is cool, so you can have your remote and your iPod on the same dock. Okay, now that we're through the manual, I'm going to get into this thing and how it actually blasts sound and all this stuff. So we're just going to turn this up. We're going to switch to AM. All right, so we're on 98.7. It's like a... So I'm not sure what... Let me turn that down. I'm not sure what this is called, but this radio actually has the ability to get text data from a radio station. I don't know the exact term for that, but maybe you guys can help me out. But this thing blasts. I'm just going to turn it up really quick. It's got its own independent subwoofer. It's got two speakers, and you also notice that the two antennas are actually unplugged, but depending on where you are, if you really can't get a signal, you can use these, but the internal antenna is pretty much enough to get crystal clear sound. And then it's got presets, it's got all these, you can plug this in the back, you can use this to control it as well, so here's the volume button. It's a nice system, you know. If you're looking to save some cash, the prices fluctuate on these, but, you know, a Bose system's like, you know, $500 to $1,000, you can pick these up for, don't quote me on this, but, you know, maybe for a few hundred bucks, and it's still a very good sound system. So I'm going to read off their Amazon listing and tell you what's going on. It's got five star customer reviews. It's got high accuracy main speakers. They deliver lifelike sound with a built-in powered subwoofer. Wide dispersion speakers deliver out-of-the-box sound. External dock connector fits your iPod. It's got 32-character display. Shows radio station information, RDS, that's what it's called. Auxiliary input down here. And auxiliary input for CDs or MP3 players or whatever you want to plug into it. And then I'm going to read the product description and what the company claims for this thing. The Cambridge SoundWorks 735 is an AM/FM table radio with stereo sound, but it sounds like no other table radio. In addition to the two full-range drivers, Cambridge integrates a subwoofer that delivers precise low frequencies that make the 735 sound like a large sound system. The 735 replaces Cambridge's successful 730 radio, which initially introduced the subwoofer concept. The 735 adds an included external iPod dock, this guy right here, and lets you play your iPod through the 735 and appreciate its wonderful sound qualities to an even higher degree. But there is an aux cable too, so you really don't even need this if you have an aux cord, that is. So let me keep going on this description. Let you play your iPod through 7, appreciate sound quality to a higher degree. The dock also doubles as a charger for your iPods. So you can charge it as well. The SoundWorks radio has 16 presets for two bands of FM tuning and 8 presets for AM reception. So you can set those presets to both AM and FM. I thought that was pretty neat. Front inputs for your CD or your MP3 player and a headphone jack. Rear inputs and outputs for recording, mixing, and outside signal reception. There's a large and easy-to-read display, a sleep timer, and two alarm settings. Everything you can expect from a quality radio, plus exquisite sound and more flexibility than you're accustomed to. Expect more from the Cambridge SoundWorks 735! Dual alarms that wake to tone or music, sleep timer, automatic dimmer reduces display brightness in dark rooms. So this thing has a light sensor, that's kind of neat. While maintaining good, let's test that theory. I'm not sure if I can get it because there's ambient light. Anyway, expect dual alarms, make it tone of music, sleep timer, reduces display. I already said that. Good legibility in bright light, 24 station programmable memory presets, 16 FM, 8 AM. Separate bass and treble controls, 48 hour alarm backup requires a 9-volt battery. I showed you that in the manual. You guys can back up your alarm with a 9-volt in case it gets unplugged or storm hits. Magnetically shielded for placement near TV or monitor screens. Convenient ultra-compact remote control. Unit dimensions are 4 inches and 15/16 of an inch high, 14 inches wide, and 9-inch, 7/8-inch depth, and it weighs 11 pounds. So this thing is really solid. Now, I know I haven't really moved the camera much in this review, and I know I've said it at the beginning, but once again, guys, as always, Amazon link below for this specific model, and we'll also have Cambridge's full line of products, and be sure to check out Chameleon.com, because we have a ton of different audio gear, everything from aux cables all the way up to high-end radio equipment, so you're definitely going to want to check that out too, guys. So here's the iPod dock. Here's the front of it. You can see how it's actually got a interface. Here's the knob.
Now we've got 13 minutes to go. We are moving on to something else.
Let the radio talk for itself. It's basically a brand new model, right out of the box. We only have 45 pairs. 735. There's the SN. People listening right now. External. And you can switch between external and internal antennas. That's kind of neat. One more time. But that's pretty much it, guys. This is a high-end piece of gear. Relatively affordable. You can get them up, pick them up for maybe a couple $100. $100, depends on the seller. This is a great radio. Would highly recommend it. Other than that, with that, guys, we're going to put this on off. And Chameleon.com is out. Amazon link below. Check it out. Buy one today for some high-end audio awesomeness. All right, Chameleon.com is out.